Good morning. It's early in the morning. I let my children stay up watching movies last night with me. Good movies for kids. And they are sleeping. They never sleep past 6 a.m. And so I decided this would be a good time to do some mama time just with me. And I wanted to show you a thing I do, which I guess people call Zentangling now. I found about it on Pinterest. And I like to start mine with a pen and some type of a stencil. This is just a lid from a Magic Bullet cup. And then I've got a bunch of different pens. You can use whatever you want. I really like pens for this because you're going to draw sort of in a really small way. So colored pencils would be good too, but then you have to sharpen them. So I personally like pens. These are like felt tip pens or fine point markers. And then you could just use a straight up lined notebook. If you use a lined notebook, you can use the lines in your design. So here's one that I've already done. You can see I only used two colors, pink and a dark purple for that one. So, I suggest that you pause the video right now and go and get some paper, but preferably a notebook, pencil or pen, and markers or fine tip point markers or pens right now. Okay, let's get started. Today I'm not going to do my circles as neatly as I did the last one. I'm going to move this just so you can see the... So, I'm going to do mine a little more random this time. Kind of feeling like a waterfall, maybe, sort of a thing today. Yeah, it's not quite even. I kind of like it that way. I am going to start with yellow. Yellow's a bright good morning color. And I'm going to just start with this top line. No, I won't start with the top. I'll start with this line here. So let's see. I think I'm going to start with just some lines. Diagonal lines. You can hardly even see that, can you? Okay. Since I've done this line here, the next one here I'm going to leave blank. Then I'll fill in the next. I'm just going to color these in. And then I'm going to continue in the line. So this had some color. This had nothing. This had some color. So this one needs to have nothing. And this one can have color. I'll do my stripes again. I'm going to switch to brighter yellow so you can see it a little better. I think I'll skip a line, so I'll skip this line. I'll do this one next. I'm just going to color it in. I color in one direction because I'm a teacher and that's how we do it at the school. Skip. Like a checkerboard. Skip. do green. Green's my favorite. I'll skip a line. I'll do dots. Skip. Dots. Skip. Dots. Oh, I forgot this one. And I forgot this. This is in the same line, see? See how this is the line? I'm going to skip this one. I'm going to do this one. I'll color in again. It's a good one to activity to do in total quiet. But it's also nice to play music when you're doing it. Skip. Skip. I'm just going to stick with green for a little while, I think. So, skip this. I'll go back to my dots. How about lines? I like lines. How about bushes or whatever, loops and bottom, top, or top and bottom, I guess. Skip. Noticing that this is in here, sort of skipped. Let's see. I give this some just. Yeah, we'll do horizontal strips. Let's see. This row's done. I guess I can give this guy a row here. Let's give him something. How about. Circles. I like to change the way I'm filling them in. Blank. When I'm using the same color to give a little bit of variety there. Texture to the page when it's done. Skip. This one's done all the way. This row's done all the way across. This one's done. This one's done. This one's done. This one. This one. Alright, I'm going to change my color again. This time I'm going to choose blue. because I think I want to do, I like butterflies a lot, so I'm going to think about a butterfly shape. So they often have like a sort of a loop like that. A few of those. And then circles. I'll do the same thing over here. These are my favorite. These are Pentel sign pens. I really, really like the tip on these for Zentangling because they're so teeny tiny. I'm a teacher, so I have a lot of school supplies. Okay, then what I'll do is I'm just going to color around those and leave those spaces empty. Maybe you have a lot of time and can do more detailed design on all your stripes if you like. I don't. I expect my children to wake up and interrupt me. And so I just reserve a few. Oops. Oh well. Lost a circle. I just take a few that are extra special. When I do this, I kind of think about Bob Ross. How he would just explain his little thing that he'd be doing. And how valuable it is to just take that, whatever it is, 10, 30 minutes. That's the thing about that's nice about having it in a notebook is you can stop. Get back to it whenever you want. Let's see. I'm going to also do a little more detail here. I think I'm going to do, well, let me just do this row first. I think I'm going to do a maze for my little detail in the next one. So you see how I'm staying inside the circles, but I'm also skipping it kind of like a checkerboard. those two lines there. Like my lines. How about a picture frame? I haven't done that yet. Picture frame. How about some words? We were talking about doing this to feel peace. How about peace? Quiet and calm. Peace. Quiet and calm. Oh, that makes me think about an ocean. Let's do some waves. I do my waves like a cursive C, kind of. Go back to my good old polka dots here. I do think I'm gonna outline these. I might go back and outline the green ones later. I don't know. Kind of liking the boldness of that, the extra pop of color. I think I like the contrast between the really darker, more saturated color and the light. I think I like to see the dark spots and the bright spots. What else? How about flowers? Thinking about what images make me feel peaceful or positive. Sometimes I've done this when I felt angry and got out those images, like lightning bolts, things broken, shattered, spider webs, things that don't make me feel great. And I think I'm just gonna do the bottom just abandon these top couple ones. really decide what color I was going to do. I love green, so I always end up defaulting back to green. Which is fine, but I don't see my other green. I want a different shade, so I'll do gray. Let's see. How about kind of like Dalmatian spots? Over in here. I'm just get down to this line, and I definitely am missing. I haven't done any silhouettes of my people, so let's see. I'm gonna do. And then she's going to have, this one's going to have locks, I think. Let's see. What does she see? She sees... she sees music. She's looking toward music. Maybe that's what she wants to create today. Behind me we can have we'll have a quilt here. We'll do a log cabin quilt. So we have a square in the middle, and then we have a strip above, and then we have a strip down the side, across the bottom, down the side, top, side, bottom, side, top, side, bottom, inside. I'm gonna color the rest of that square black, since this supposed to be a gray, but it turns out it looks more like black. And let's just give us a little blackness right there. Let's just do it. Can tell when I get a little bit antsy and I would sort of be like, oh, let's finish. But the point is to take my time doing something slowly, so I have to stop. My breathe a little bit. Slow down. So I'm now at the point where I've done some work in every single line. Oh, I think when I hold it up, I just noticed I skipped some blue. Yeah, right here. I hope this is the right blue. I don't think that's the right blue. Maybe it was this one. Save because I didn't finish this one across. If I did this one, I should have done this. And then I should have done this. Feathers, which I do very similar to leaves. I think I make them a little curlier on the edge. That's what the difference is between feathers and feathers always have those wispy pieces that fall off. Okay, so I'm done. You can call this done. I suggest signing your name and the date at the bottom so you can track your progress. I think this is the 13th. Yeah, I can call that done. Hope that was fun. Hope it was peaceful. See you again. Very soon.